here today to celebrate the choice of Andy and Irene to marry. We will witness the joining of their families, hear their statement of intent, vow, and decision to choose one another as life partners. The choice of marriage echoes the action of our ancestors who came together in love. You and I, as participants and observers, are witnesses of this ceremony where love flourishes. Andy and Irene have chosen to call their community together in this simple and beautiful barn because their farm and community are essential elements in their lives. They have worked to transform this barn into a space for the wedding and for future unicycling activities. What a special way to remember their wedding day when using this space. You may be all be seated. Notice all who are gathered here today. Let us call upon those who are with us in spirit only. And let us say to one another, peace and greetings to all. Please take a moment to turn to your neighbors and say hello.
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 Video.
Andy and Irene come to this ceremony today as adults making a free choice to join their lives together. Their love for each other is grounded in the love they enjoy and share with their family and friends. We are reminded that this marriage is not only a celebration of the family they are creating, but also a thanksgiving for their families of birth who have loved them. And so I ask today, who comes here with Andy to welcome Irene to her family?
We do.
Who comes here today with Irene to welcome Andy to their family?
We do.
Are you two families willing to acknowledge the bond that this marriage makes among you, and are you willing to share together all that lies ahead?
We are.
Andy and Irene met through unicycling and have traveled to 14 different countries together, sharing their love of the sport. They are married now because they have decided to spend their lives together. Irene loves that Andy leads by example, explains his thoughts logically, is open to new experiences, foods, and change. He is loving and supportive in her endeavors. He knows how to make her laugh and find the humor in situations. Andy challenges Irene to grow when he takes on new projects. Irene's knowledge has been expanded in ways she never would have thought possible. He has taught her how to properly fertilize the garden and how to start seedlings inside. He has also shared his knowledge with organizing events and guiding her through how to book lodging for 15 people during a unicycle tour through France. Irene believes she can make this marriage last a lifetime because she has found someone with many of the same interests as her. Andy is supportive of her activities and willing to grow and change. Irene wishes to say to Andy on her wedding day that she is so happy she found him. Andy loves Irene's willingness to try new things, her great sense of humor, her culinary ability, her love of exercise and travel. Irene challenges Andy to grow by encouraging him, being straightforward, and by positive reinforcement. Andy believes he can make this marriage last a lifetime because of Irene's ability to talk things through, travel to new places, her willingness to God, to give and take, her big heart, and because she accepts him for who she is, who he is. And he is so happy to remind Andy and Irene of the privilege and wonder of committed relationships as they struggle with tough spots in their lives. It exists to support them in their daily decision to remain in partnership. As Andy and Irene's community, you also assume the responsibility to support them and their relationship in times of stress as well as in times of joy. If you are willing to give your verbal support, please respond after me with, "Andy and Irene, we are witnesses of your intention and we pledge you our support."
Andy and Irene, we are witnesses of your intention and we pledge you our support.
It is my charge to speak about Andy and Irene's relationship and how they are prepared for the commitment of marriage. When I think of Andy and Irene, this beautiful couple that stands before us today, I think of a whole host of excellent qualities that have made them strong as individuals and as partners. Qualities that will serve them far into their future, together as the foundation of a solid marriage. I think of their adventurous spirit. They are wonderfully curious travelers of the world, whether on unicycle or on foot. Irene in her year of studies in Nantes, the two together in their trip to Morocco, and both on their many unicycle tours across parts of North America, throughout Europe, Vietnam, and Australia. Adventurers can never be complacent or bored, even if they remain in a familiar place. Their minds stay active, imagining new journeys, other communities, greater perspectives on one's life and place in the world. Wherever they are, in Saigon or Hutchinson, the Acropolis or Minneapolis, a ferry in Norway or a Muni trail on this farm, Irene and Andy will fill each other's lives with excitement and the childlike spirit of experiencing things for the first time. Consider how they support one another. I am not sure how one measures love, but if it is in the way one cares for another, Andy and Irene have enough love for 100 couples. People may say Andy is a tough guy with his Harley Davidson, filtered with cigarettes, and full body tattoos. But I am here to tell you, Andy is a teddy bear. Truly, he melts around his beloved Irene. He is always ready for the professional massage and gives her tremendous comfort and encouragement. And while people may say, Irene is a wild one, with her bar fights, wrestling antics, and her mouth of a sailor, I am here to tell you also, Irene is a teddy bear. She is tender and nurturing. And while both are strong and independent, how wonderful when life's discomfort, challenges, and crises can be met together, softened by the hand of one's beloved. Irene and Andy, for want of a better expression, will always be there for one another. Just these two qualities, adventurous spirit and mutual support, would be enough to sustain a couple for a lifetime. But they also possess two more essential qualities I wish to highlight, these belonging to the world of laughter and to art. Andy is a very funny fellow, and fortunately he has a good audience in Irene who laughs freely and long at his delicious sense of humor and fun. Likewise, Irene has an infectiously mirthful spirit, and if her jokes and sweet laughter are comical and absurd in the world, Andy finds a perfect partner. Life may not always be a rollicking, hilarious adventure, but to have a partner who can lift one's spirits in times of sadness or trouble, someone who can find a way to tickle your funny bone in nearly any situation, that is worth more than a Swiss bank account, though not quite as much as Bill Gates Foundation. Finally, Andy and Irene will continue throughout their lives to